Hey.
So this one review is audio in device you're going to be listening quality audio.
And as new parents, we start to say, please turn off all of your phones, ringers, alarms, anything that will interrupt this new normal today. Please be sure to no videos during the ceremony and no pictures.
Thank you.
and gentlemen, may we please stand for the entrance of the bride.
Soberly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. And it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. And it always preserves. There are three pillars upon which a marriage must be built: faith, hope, and love. The greatest of these three is love. So now, since you have come to this place, I charge the both of you who stand now in the presence of God to remember that love and the faithful observance of your marriage vows are required as the foundation of a successful marriage and the establishment of a happy, joyful, peaceful, and enduring home. Without these, there can be no real marriage, and the home which you endeavor to establish will be in vain and fruitless in your efforts. Keep the solemn vows you're about to make. Live in tender consideration of each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth, and your marriage will last, and your home will endure. The marriage bond will be a blessing to you, and you will be a blessing to each other. This should be remembered as you take your vows to declare your desire to be wed one to another. Joseph Anthony Anderson, do you take this woman, Amber Rochelle James, to be your wedded wife, and do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love her, that you will comfort her, that you will honor and keep her in infirmity and in wellness, and that forsaking all others, for her alone will you perform unto her all the duties that her husband owes to his loving wife, until God by death shall separate you. To you, Amber Rochelle James, do you take this man, Joseph Anthony Anderson, to be your wedded husband, and do you solemnly promise before God and these witnesses that you will love him, that you will comfort him, that you will honor and keep him in infirmities and in wellness, and that forsaking all others to him alone, you will perform unto him all the duties that a wife owes to her husband, to God by death, such shall break you. Who gives this woman to marry this man? Thank you. It sounds good. It delivers. But there's another idea in marriage. 50-50 apart from you. You must bring 100% to the marriage. 100 from you. And 100 from you. Will each of you do that? So then, Joseph Anthony Emerson, will you take Dee Amber Michelle James to be your wedded wife, to have in the role from this day forward, for better or for worse, for abundance or for adversity, in wellness and in infirmity, to love and to cherish, to death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto plight thee her faith. To you, Amber Michelle James, do you take Joseph Anthony Anderson to be your wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for abundance or in adversity, in infirmity and in wellness, to love and to cherish, to death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and that you not like me, my faith. To you, Anthony, what token do you give as a symbol of your love for me? To you, man, what token of love do you give for Anthony? Amen. Father, would you bless this now? These rings will come completely and uniquely made, without any evidence of a brokenness in them. No one can discern the beginning or the end whence it was made. No union,
nothing
was separated from your love and from that love for one another.
We pray for them all.
We pray that they have joy and power. May not be one love will abide among them. And that whatever comes against this marriage, we will not believe. And when differences will arise,
Amen.